Hello student, welcome once again in our standard 7 lesson number 10 mathematics practical geography geometry not geography student. Before starting our today's sessions, let's do little physical and silent prayer exercise. I hope so you all are ready with your stationaries, compass box, etc. In our last sessions, we completed our introductions of practical geometry. Lesson number 10, standard 7, mathematics. My dear student, you are knowing very well, this lesson is very, very important for your SSC class. Because in SSC, the questions of construction will be asked. Yes. It will be a 4 marks, 5 marks questions are there from these types of questions. Here is the exercise 10.1. You can see the question number 1 on your screen. Draw a line, say AB, take a point C outside it. Through C, draw a line parallel to AB using ruler and compass only. Compasses only. But our compass is not that our compass. It's a pair of compass. It's a pair of compass. Is it? So you can get the idea what you have to use. My dear student, here you can think about a rough sketch of your construction. It is called the construction. Line drawing is a construction, but parallel line. Do you know what is a parallel line, students? In last sessions, in last year also, we know these things. Line AB is parallel to line CD. Isn't it? Because the distance between these two lines remain the equal from beginning to end. That means it's a parallel line. Sometime you can find these types of line also. We studied in last year, line AB is parallel to line CD. Isn't it? And here angle is formed 90 degree. 90 degree angle when it is formed two lines or a cutting lines also, like vice versa. It is called the line CD, which is cutting on point M or point O, whatever you can say. But the angle from this one is a 90 degree, which called a perpendicular line. It is showing like this way. Line AB is perpendicular to line CD. And for this one, line AB is parallel to line CD. Isn't it? You should have to remember these types of things. Last year also we completed these types of things. Now we are going to construct a parallel line where line AB is given and you should have to draw a line CD. Here point C is outside of point. Yes, my dear student, outside of point C is lying on not AB but outside of line AB. And through that C, we should have to draw a line CD which is parallel to line AB. So here are the steps how to construct it. My dear student, first of all, you should have to draw a line which is measure not given but can say AB and C is the outside point where CD line you have to prepare. Yes, look at here. To construct, what you are going to construct, dear student, you are going to construct a line parallel to given line by using ruler and compasses. Steps of constructions. Remember this heading, students. You should have to write to construct steps of construction also. A. Draw a line segment AB and take a point C outside of AB. Take any point D on AB and join C to D. Okay. With D as center and take convenient radius, draw an arc cutting AB at E and CD at F. With C as center and same radius as in step 3. Draw an arc GH cutting CD at L. Yes, my dear student, take here point E. With the same arc EF, draw the equal arc cutting GH at J. Join JC to draw a line L. Here, this line AB and line L is the parallel. It is a parallel line symbol. See, student, AB is parallel to L, line L. Here we are writing with the alphabets AB as a line and L is also a line. Isn't it clear? Let's check. Is it correct or wrong? My dear student, points are already given. We have to follow one by one to construct. Yes, what you are going to construct? A line which is parallel to given line by using ruler and compasses. Steps of constructions, whatever are given. You see the picture downside. I already drawn the AB and then point C is also there. Now from D point, I can draw a, yes, my dear student, arc EF, which is cutting a F. Yes, same way from the C, I can make an arc HG, GH, which is cutting on J and on L. Yes, my dear student, which is make me a C and J, use a line L, which is parallel to line AB. Okay, correct. Line AB is parallel to line L. My dear student, you just follow the steps one by one. It is called the construction, not a drawing. But a construction is little different one than a drawing. Drawing has no steps and nothing to measure. But here, each and everything you should have to follow according to the questions and measurements also. Look at the question number 2. Draw a line L, draw a perpendicular to L at any point on L. On this perpendicular, choose a point X 4 cm away from L. Through X, draw a line M parallel to L. Answers once again. Put the practice to write like this way. What we are going to construct? A line parallel to given line when perpendicular line is also given. Steps. You can write steps in your words also. It is not compulsory what is given here or what is given in your solution book or anywhere. You can make your statement, but steps remain the same, answer remain the same. Draw a line L and take a point P on it. At point P, draw a perpendicular line and take PX is equal to 4 cm on a line N. At point X, again draw a perpendicular line M. It is the required construction. The last step should be like this way only. It is the required construction which is asked in the question. Easy? Will you try yourself? Okay, first time you have little difficulties, but afterwards you can get the little confidence. When we complete this exercise, you have the little more confidence how to draw it. Isn't it? So now you have clear idea regarding a perpendicular line and a parallel line. Because now you drawn yourself, construct yourself, which will help you. Yes, my dear student, it is correct. Now, 4 cm away. Correct, you are right, my. Look at the question number 3. Let L be a line and P be a point not on L. Through point P, draw a line M parallel to line L. Now, join P to any point Q on L. Choose any other point R on M. Through R, draw a line parallel to PQ. Let this meet L at S. What shape do the two sets of parallel lines enclosed? Construction, what we are going to construct? A pair of parallel lines intersecting other part of the parallel lines. Yes, corresponding angle, alternate angle. Yes, very good, very good. Opposite, vertically opposite angle also you can form it. Here, steps are there. Draw a line L and take a point P outside of L. P kahan pe liya beta? Outside of L. Apne line ye banaya, uske andar P point kya liya? Outside pe liya hai. Kahan liya beta? Ye line banaya L. और P पॉइंट क्या लिया है? R लाइन के बाहर की जगह पे. क्लियर? ओके. take a point Q on line L and join PQ. Then after you have to draw a line PQ. Make equal angle at point P such that angle Q and angle P are equal. Yes, my dear student, it is called the alternate angle. Extend line at P to get line M. Similarly, take a point R on line M. At point R, draw angles such that angle P and angle R are also equal. Extended line at R which intersects at point S on line L. On and line are separate words. Draw line RS, thus we get parallelogram PQRS. Parallelogram means opposite sides are equal and parallel. Two pairs of lines are parallel. It is called the parallelogram. You remember this word? Yes, in our quadrilateral we studied these things. What you have to draw? Clear it? Very good student. Very nice. Correct. Now look at the exercise 10.2. In here, this question is little bit different because in this exercise, now we are going to construct a triangle. My dear student, it is a triangle. As we discussed earlier, a triangle is nothing but it's a combination of three lines, three angles, and three vertices. Yes, my dear student, here is the line 1, line 2, and line 3. And three vertices, 1, 2, and 3. Three lines, yes, this is the three lines, okay. Three angles, yes, very good student, three angles. And three vertices, 1, 2, and 3. So, three means triangle. Three angles, use can of the air, triangles, correct. Now, in this exercise, you are going to construct a triangle by some criterion. We already discussed in our introduction sessions, but I remind you here SAS. What is there, beta? SAS. SAS. Is it it? Yes, my dear student. SAS. That's what is the SAS? Yes, side angle side. Dusra hai beta ASA. Angle side angle. Pehla tha actually SSS. 3S. Side, SAS, ASH and RHS. In char property ka use karke hum triangle bana sakte hai. If these things are there, then and then only it will be constructed. Second thing, sum of two sides. Suppose A plus B, two sides are there, is always greater than third side. Tisri side se badi honi chahiye. To hi ye construction ban sakta hai, varna banega nahi. Aur ek chautha, total is a 180 degree. Sum of all three angles is 180 degree. These are the properties of the triangle. Here the measures of triangle XYZ is given. XY is equal to 4.5 centimeters. And yes, my dear student, it is gone. Okay, I will take it back for you. Here XY is equal to 4.5, YZ is equal to 5, and ZX is equal to 6 centimeters. Easy steps are there. First of all, YZ banao ya koi bhi banao, koi problem nahi beta. Correct. Taking a Z point and make the arc of 6 cm, taking the Y as a center and draw an arc of 4.5 cm, which are cutting on point X. Now join point XY and XZ. It is required triangle XYZ. Easy or not? I shown with the green color pen. Look at a question number 2. Construct an equilateral triangle of side 5.5 cm. But I have a key measurement diya. How to understand these things? Yes, you are right. You are right, 100% right. Equilateral triangle means all three sides are equal. So all three sides having the measure 5.5 cm. Very simple. You can take any name and draw it. Here PQR given. So draw the PQR and 5.5 centimeters. In second question, it was the ABC or ABC you have to take, then write down the ABC's measurement, because in this example AB, BC and CA is equal to 5.5 centimeter, because in question already specified equilateral triangle of 5.5 centimeter. Now look at the question number 3. draw a triangle PQR with PQ is equal to 4 cm, QR is equal to 3.5 cm and PR is equal to 4 cm. Here all the sides are different or equal? No, here two sides are equal and one is different. That gives you a isosceles triangle. Is it or not? Yes, sometimes they can ask, draw an isosceles triangle whose measure of sides are 4 cm and 3.5 cm, where 4 cm is common for both the sides. Okay, once again I will take it the third one, so you can get the idea how to draw it. कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्ड करने का है, अब बना दो, स्टेप्स लिख दो, अपने हिसाब से आपको स्टेप्स लिखने का है. सो वॉट एवर इज गिवन हियर आप अपने लैंग्वेज में भी लिख सकते हैं, इजी स्टेप्स. क्लियर? सो डोंट स्टिक ऑन दिस इज द फाइनल आंसर. हाँ, योर कंस्ट्रक्शन रिमेन द ऑल कंस्ट्रक्शन आर सेम बट स्टेप्स मे बी डिफरेंट वन. आइसोसेलेस ट्राइंगल, लुक एट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. कंस्ट्रक्ट ट्राइंगल ए बी सी such that AB is equal to 2.5 cm, BC is equal to 6 cm and AC is equal to 6.5 cm and also measure of angle B. What is the measure of angle B? Yes, what is the measure of angle B we should have to measure at last? Yes, first of all draw the triangle with the given measurement. Yes, so many students can take AB down as a base, no problem. The answer remains the same always. Clear? Okay. It should be 80 degree. Now look at the question number 1 of exercise 10.3. Here exercise is very very small, one or two examples are there, but very important are there. Construct a triangle DEF such that D is equal to 5 cm, DF is equal to 3 cm and measure of angle EDF is equal to 90 degree. Yes, you are right my dear student, it's a right angle triangle. Take anyone as a base and next of the legs. Now construct DF such that D is equal to 5 cm, we will put it downside and DF is a 3 cm, measure of angle D, EDF is equal to 90 degree. Yes, if you are taking 5 as the base or 3 as the base as it is, the answer remains the same but angle D should be 90 degree. Steps I will not force to write this way. I already explained the middle term is showing you the angle XYZ, उसमें Y है वो angle दिखाता है. Construct an isosceles triangle in which the length of each of its equal sides is 6.5 cm and the angle between them is 110 degree. Answer number 2, to construct an isosceles triangle PQR where PQ is equal to RQ is equal to 6.5 cm and angle Q is equal to 110 degree. Steps of construction, draw a line segment QR is equal to 6.5 cm at point PQ, draw an angle of 110 degree with the help of protractor. Yes, 110 knot can be possible with pair of compass. Question number 3, construct a triangle ABC with BC is equal to 7.5 cm, AC is equal to 5 cm and measure of angle C is equal to 60 degree. Here, what the things are given beta? Yes, S, A, S. Is it or not? Yes, it is written clearly like that way only. Okay, so what you are going to do here to construct a triangle ABC where BC is equal to 7.5 cm, AC is equal to 5 cm and angle measure C is equal to 60 degree. Steps of construction, draw a line segment BC is equal to 7.5 cm. Yes, very good student. At point P, draw an angle of 60 degree with the help of protractor or pair of compass, it is possible. That means angle of XCB is equal to 60 degree. Here X is written directly, A is not specified. We are going to find the point A. Is it or not? See, once again I want to show you. Taking a C as center and measure radius 5 cm which cut XC at point A. Now join AB which gives us a triangle ABC of given measure. Exercise number 10.4, question number 1 of standard 7,
लेसन नंबर 10 प्रैक्टिकल ज्योमेट्री कंस्ट्रक्शन ट्रायंगल एबीसी व्हाट द थिंग्स आर गिवन मेजर ऑफ एंगल ए इज इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री मेजर ऑफ एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू 30 डिग्री एंड ए बी इज इक्वल टू 5.8 सेंटीमीटर हियर ए एस ए एंगल साइड एंगल क्राइटेरियन यू आर गोइंग टू यूज व्हाट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट दैट यू हैव टू राइट इट एंड देन आफ्टर द स्टेप्स Once again, I will remind you, you can write your steps in your way. Whatever the measurement is given, draw it the line first and then after both the side, with the help of protractor or pair of compass, draw the angle 60 degree and 30 degree. Yes, my dear student, your angle A is equal to 60 degree, angle B is equal to 30 degree. And also, the measure of side AB is equal to 5.8 centimeter, which you are drawing with the help of the scale. Is it or wrong? Yes. Here, how to draw the angle of 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree? Yes. It is written here clearly how to draw it. Okay? Oh, some students still now confused how to draw it. See, I will show you. First of all, draw a single line. Take any point 1 here. Draw an arc of any size of radius. Okay, now take the point from here with the same radius, cut it. With the same radius, you can cut second one. So, where you are cutting first one, which makes you a 60 degree. How much degree, beta? 60 degree. Again, you are going through it. This is also 60. And this is also 60 degree. Degree sign is there. Don't forget to put 60, 60, 60. Okay, straight line we are knowing. How much degree is there straight line? It's a 180. Sum it all together. It's a 60, 60 plus 60, 180 is there? Yes, correct. Now from this point, you can draw an arc with the same measure here. And from this point, you can draw an arc from here. Now intersection of this one will give you a half of the 60 degree, which gives you a 30 degree. How much is this student beta? 30 and 30 this one, 30 plus 30, 60. Same way here, if you are making the bisector of these two angles, is a 30 degree, 30 plus 30, 60. But 30 plus 60 will give you a 90 degree. So that's why here it's a 90 degree. Clear? So sometimes of these types of knowledge is very, very useful to you to understand how it can possible without protractor. Isn't it? Clear. Now question number 2. Construct a triangle PQR if PQ is equal to 5 cm, measure of angle PQR is equal to 105 degree and measure of angle QRP is equal to 40 degree centigrade. Centigrade no beta, it is a centigrade will come where? Yes, in temperature it is coming, here only degree. Steps, oh, things are given here. Now new things you have to find out. Angle diya hai do, barabar, ek side bhi diya hai. तो बनाएंगे नो इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल हियर बिकॉज दिस एंगल इज नॉट इंक्लूडेड ए साइड दिस बोथ एंगल आर नॉट इंक्लूडेड ए साइड सो फाइंड द थर्ड एंगल एंगल क्यू पी आर 35 डिग्री हाउ टू फाइंड इट दिस वन वी आर नोइंग एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ट्राइंगल इज 180 डिग्री एंड फाइंड आउट द थर्ड एंगल ऑल्सो यस नाउ यूजिंग दिस प्रॉपर्टी यू कैन फाइंड टू कंस्ट्रक्ट ए ट्राइंगल Question number 3. Examine whether you can construct triangle DF such that EF is equal to 7.2 cm, measure of angle E is equal to 110 degree and measure of angle F is equal to 80 degree. Justify your answers. Yes, my dear student, given things are here, using angle sum property, we check out. Is it possible? It is not possible because of this one. Left side is angle D plus angle E plus F is equal to 108 degree, 110 plus 80 which gives you 190 degree. Whenever we are going to find angle D is equal to, that one is a minus 10. That is not possible. That's why it is a wrong question. Exercise number 10.5, standard 7, mathematics, lesson number 10, practical geometry. Exercise number 10.5, question 1. Construct the right angle triangle PQR where angle Q is equal to 90 degree, angle not given, one angle and two sides, QR is equal to 8 cm and PR is equal to 10 cm. what we are going to construct? A right angle triangle PQR where angle Q is equal to 90 and QR is equal to 8, PQ is equal to 10 cm. Yes, steps you are having. Here you can use the property of perpendicular lines. Is it? Yes. At point Q, you can construct a QX and QR perpendicular lines. And now you are having the measures, hypotenuse in a side and also, yes, 90 degree, RHS, right angle, hypotenuse and one side. Construct a right angle triangle whose hypotenuse is 6 cm long and one leg is 4 cm. Here no name is given. You can select any name of the triangle as you wish, not compulsory. But whenever the questions having the perfect specified name, you have to use that name only. Clear? A right angle triangle DF, where DF is equal to 6 cm and EF is equal to 4 cm. Is it? Question number 3. Construct an isosceles right angle triangle ABC where measure of angle ABC, ACB is equal to 90 degree and AC is equal to 6. Here student, AC is 6 cm, so BC is also 6 cm. Why? Because already said isosceles right triangle. So here rough idea is also given. And C is the middle one, ACB, not ABC is written. Okay. Miscellaneous questions are also given. You can follow it very clearly what you have to find it. Is it? Okay, very good student. So some questions are given here. So you can go through it. Below are given the measures of certain sides and angles of triangles. Identify those which cannot be constructed and say why you cannot construct them. Construct rest of the triangle. Answer why beta? A angle A 85, angle B 105, AB is equal to 5. Construction of triangle ABC is not possible because 85 plus 115, which gives a 200 sides, and our sum of angle property of a triangle is 180, which is greater than 180. That's why it is not possible. Answer number 2. Construct PQR where angle Q is equal to 30 degree. Yes, second one only. Angle P is equal to 60 and 4.7 cm, which is possible. Yes or no? Yes. Let's check it. Two sides not given, but two angle and in between one side. QR side diya beta, angle Q diya, angle R. It is possible. Angle, side, angle criterion, ASA. Answer number 3. Here is also, we are knowing angle sum property is 180 degrees, so triangle ABC, can we find the angle of C? Why not? Angle of C also 60 degree. So using this criterion, we made it AC angle and AC is the side and it is possible. So it is a required triangle is possible, but here you have to find out the third angle. Okay, correct. Now look at here, question number 4, LMN, where 60 degree and 120, which makes you a 180. So what about the third angle? It is not possible. It's a linear pair of angles, isn't it? So do aa gaya beta, linear pair ban gaya. Answer number 5. ABC, isme BC is equal to 2, AB is equal to 4 and AC is equal to 2. Here we are knowing the sum of two sides is always greater than third one. But here sum of two sides is 2 plus 2, 4 and 4 is equal to 4. That's why it is not possible. So this type of construction is not possible. Or you can say triangle is not possible. Answer number 6. Yes, once again fifth one. And 6th one is here, triangle PQR where PQ is equal to 3. QR is equal to 4 and PR is equal to 3.5. Ab iske sath plus karke dekho beta, to ho jayega isosceles triangle. Is it? Correct. It is a required triangle PQR where two sides are equal. and sum of two sides is always greater than third one. This property also you have to follow. Question number 7. A triangle whose side is xy is equal to 3 cm, y is equal to 4 and xz is equal to 5. Here is it is also possible. You can go through any side and construct a triangle. Yes, you can take the base xy also downside. You can take the xz also as a base downside. Base means niche ki side beta. There are 4 cm there. Some are taking xy. No problem. Question number 8. A triangle DF whose sides are D is equal to 4.5 cm, AF is equal to this one and DF is equal to this one. It is also required triangle, take the any base and construct it as per your requirement. Because 3 sides are given S criterion, side and check it. Sum of 2 sides are greater than of 2 sides. Yes, once again, thank you. Bye-bye.